And we'll go to the second speaker, Yuri Rinkus.
Go ahead. Thank you, Professor Chair, professors, dear adjuvants. First of all, I would like to thank the chairman of our meetings and the organizers of this conference for the opportunity to speak and present the results of my current research. My name is Yuri Rinkus. I represent Kharkov University of Economics in Poland.
Yuri, do you want to turn today your
camera? Excuse me, if the internet speed is slow, maybe turning the video may not be a good idea.
Okay. I have divided my short report into four sections. First of all, I will start with presentation of human capital measurement model and fair pay. This model would not have been developed without discovery of the economic constant. Therefore, secondly, I will present open research on estimating the economic constant based on the minimum wage in USA and next based on wage expectation in Ukraine. Finally, we will present other carried out of our research on economic constant. Let me turn now to the first point. Thermodynamics enables a deeper understanding of the nature of capital and perception, the complementary of the capital and labor, from which follows a set of basic economic concepts. On this ground, I developed a human capital measurement model and fair pay model. These two fundamental models presented themselves like on the next slide. These models are based on fundamental laws of reality. The first and second laws of thermodynamics and the principle of minimal action, especially the second law of thermodynamics in its basic formulation is indispensably in economic considerations because the human body has a features of a high heat engineer and experiences spontaneous random dispersion of energy. Empirical studies have revealed that this dispersion has average value 8% per year. Therefore, in the economic science was discovered the first constant. This value is the key developing fair pay models has allowed the answer to the variety of questions, such as, for example, is the legal minimum wage in the USA fair? First of all, it must be said what we mean by fair pay. Translated into real terms, fair pay means that earnings of two working parents allow the two descendants to reach the level of human capital they achieve. What is means that this wage guarantees the preservation of human capital. The fair of the minimum wage in the USA is manifested in practice by the desire to migrate to the USA, which is a known fact. But let's check it on the numbers based on our calculation on a family of four. Fairness of the minimum wage in the USA is confirmed by the calculations made on the average value of living costs and wages. Please note the next slide. As we can see, on computing the present frame, presents earns at the average minimum wage per hour and its average minimum wage from all states. We go at $3,168. After adding 6.2% social security tax and 1.45% Medicare tax paid by the employer, the total family income is $3,410.
Assuming 20% on pension fund and 10% on health care, the income remaining in a family of four is $2,387. Per person, it will be $597, which is more than $577. It's the average living cost per person for family of four. And this calculation proves that the level of the minimum wage in the USA guarantees the preservation of human capital. From this, we can conclude that the examined wage has a fair pay. This study has led to another confirmation of existence of the economic constant. Let's see to a pool of empirical studies that confirm the existence of this constant and its value equal to 8% per year. We will start from estimation the constant based on the minimum wage in the USA. In the case of the minimum wage, the model of human capital is equal to capitalized living cost because it concerns 17 years old teenager without professional education and experience. Due to the fact that capitalized living costs are determined by the formula shown on the slide, comes to the formula for estimation of value of P. And the next slide represents comparison of calculation results of the value of P for several selected states based on the formula presented in the previous slide. For example, let's look at Washington, D.C. Public knowledge is that in Washington, D.C., beginning July 1st, 2019, the minimum wage will increase to $14 per hour for all workers. Adding 7.65% of the employer's cost, this amount, we obtain the value of $15 per hour. On a monthly basis, it is $2,652. Monthly living costs in Washington, D.C. Is estimated at $848. Substituting this date into the formula, P-value is obtained at the level close to 0.0834. In other selected states, as you can see, estimation leads to similar results. The results of the calculation contained in Table 1 confirm that the minimum wage in the USA is determined by the constant P, and its value is at a level close to 8% per year. Another research was done on the date that comes from five different regions of Ukraine. Service war prepared obtained date from government office for job seeker. 3,920 people were surveyed by asking about expected earnings and collecting data necessary for calculating the value of human capital. Choosing place for collecting the result date for survey was dictated by the fact that the job seekers does not exhibit excessive expectations, but they take into regard mainly their cost of living. The survey contained five questions about gender, age, education, work experience, and expected pay in the event of employment. This information constitutes the basis of for estimating the value of human capital of the respondents. Converting the fair pay model to the next form, a basic equation was obtained, into which substituting the expected salary and the estimated value of human capital of the respondents were determining the size of the average value of contents P from the service date set. The obtained calculation results are presented on the slide. As can be seen from Table 2, in the group of 3,920 respondents, the average value of P in the light of the wage expectation is at a level close to 8%. The constant estimation P also can be made using fixed point theorems. For example, Banach theorem. This function ensures the convergence of subsequent iterations. Taking the value of the first approximation, P0, at the level of 0.1, after six approximation, the fixed point was reached for all service items. The obtained fixed point of the examined function have given the average value of the search and calls at the level of 0.0799. Around these words was identified the largest concentration of calculation results. Thus, application Banach's iteration method, resulting from theorem of the fixed point, confirmed size of the constant P at a percent. The constant P can also be identified and measured on the basis of data on periodic earnings and returns on stocks. Such a sort has previously been done in assessing risk premium. It appears a question of where periodic incomes come from. An answer is associated with recognizing that income on effective market as a result of, among other, the action of natural force. After all, raw materials was paid, employees received their wages, depreciation of fixed assets also increased cost. So it is possible that the force of natural the source of periodical increase in invested capital. Therefore, the value of P is assessed as a real rate of return achieved in an effective market. Let's consider it in more details based on the data in Table 3. To calculate the rate of return, the percentage of inflation was subtracted from the return of stocks, which gives a value 9.27%. It's calculated according to the arithmetic average, whereas according to the geometric average, it is 7.39%. This range includes the average long-term rate on return achieved on the American capital market. To arrive to score was calculate the arithmetic mean of these two numbers and was obtained a value of 8.285%. For stock market and reporting corporate profit, the date indicate the value at the end of the accounting year. Therefore, if capital grows at the rate of 8% ex ante, then at the end of the year exposed, it achieved level about 8.33%. Thus, the estimation specifies economic constant P equal 8% per year.
4 minutes.
Rate of returns on invested capital in business in its world tested by Bartosz Kurek. His research considered the rate of capital increase in internetership. So unlike Gozman and Ibotson, who were looking for a risk premium when setting their aims, Bartosz Kurek examines the real rate of return. The service was conducted on a sample of financial statements of corporates belonging to the Standard and Poor's 1500 for the period of 20 years. The total number of observations obtained was 22,952, and the study was conducted at a confidence level of 0.999. And other information you can see on the slide. The result of statistical research confirmed the hypothesis about the average value of risk premium exposed in the dimension of 8.33%, which corresponds to the 8% risk premium ex ante. As we could see, there are many areas in which we constant P manifested itself and its value can be estimated.
2 minutes.
History also provides interesting information. According to Pilkulska Robaskevich in the Republic of Rome, the interest rate on granting a loan was legally limited and defined as 8.33% per annum. As a conclusion, I would I would like to say that research on capital in economics has led to the identification of a real colored natural premium. It measures the activities of nature and human wise work. Research presented in this presentation shows that the average value of a random variable determining spontaneous dispersion of capital turns out to be a concept resembling a natural economic constant. There is no theoretical possibility to determining whether this constant. It can be only estimated in empirical studies. And the estimators show that this value is very stable. But the most important thing is that this constant determines the fair wage, which eliminates the natural spontaneous dispersion of human capital. Thank you very much for your attention.
Okay, thank you. It's close to on time. I'm not, since all the presentations are similar topic. Yeah, maybe we'll move on to the next speaker since all these talks are similar.